a lost piece of history now found. These photos on display at the Australian War Memorial are an important record of everyday life in World War I and have been hidden away for nearly 100 years. Discovered in an attic in the small town of Vignacourt in northern France, these thousands of photos show the life of Aussie diggers behind the front lines.
Well, there were many photographs taken during the First World War. Lots of soldiers had their photographs taken before they left Australia, in studios in Australia, as well as in studios while they were overseas. This collection and these photographs are different because they show soldiers that have just come off the front line. They show soldiers who have been marching all day. And so these photographs are different and are significant because they show us a very intimate portrait of the soldiers.
And amongst these photos is an unidentified Indigenous soldier.
It's a record of Indigenous service. It's something you can put up there. It's a proud thing. Here's this man against all kinds of odds, joined the Defence Force. And he's sitting with a person who's probably his friend. And they don't see colour. They just see two mates. This is, you know, it's about reconciliation. It's about serving your country. It's about doing the right thing.
Gary Oakley is trying to figure out just who this soldier is.
We don't know his name. But when you look at his uniform and his badges and his cowl patch, he's either a medium trench mortarman or he's a bomber. He's a specialist, he's been trained as a specialist. And I'd say that the guy he's sitting next to, the guy, is a mate of his, who knows him. But really, that's about all we know about him. When you look at those Vignacourt photographs, they look like they've just come back from the line for a rest, which means they've been frontline fighting. He's been through trench warfare. And if he's a mortarman, they used to call them the shoot and scoot brigade. So he's a guy that's right up in the front line. You know, he's a proper combat soldier. So, I mean, he could have been through, who knows? He could have gone through the Battle of Fromelles. He could even be a Gallipoli veteran, for all we know.
The exhibition has sparked nationwide interest, with people hoping to find their relatives in amongst the pictures.
The general public has really responded to this exhibition, and part of that, I think, is due to the unknown nature of the collection and of the identities of the soldiers. There is a sense of hope that families cling to, that they will find one of their relatives in amongst these photographs. And when we do make those connections, it's really great to see families connect back to their past in that way.
Despite laws forbidding Indigenous men from signing up, this unidentified soldier is just one of many Indigenous soldiers in World War I. It's reported that close to 400 Indigenous soldiers served, but it's now believed the number is closer to 1,000. For Indigenous families, the search for relatives is full of challenges.
The trouble with chasing Aboriginal people in the First World War is a lot of them didn't join under their own name, or they lied about their nationality. So you'll get guys who are Indigenous but said they were Maori. They might have picked a name that was from the station where they were. They might, like Murray, you know, I'm born on the banks of the Murray River, so I'll use the name Murray. You know, and recruiters were looking for soldiers. They weren't really going to chase your history up. And that makes it even harder because people don't know. The unfortunate thing with that is they got killed. That's the name they're buried under, not their own name, which makes it even twice as hard to find them.
The recognition of the importance of Indigenous soldiers in Australian history is an ongoing struggle.
As soon as you got back to Australia and stepped on that boat and went home, you went back to what you were before the war. You went back into society that treated you not as an equal. You were basically managed by whatever government agency managed Indigenous Australians within whatever state. And that skewed the idea of how many Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders served, because you didn't get to march on Anzac Day, you just vanished. We are quiet achievers. We achieve, we go back to community, we vanished. The unfortunate thing about doing that is nobody realised, yes, we had served.
Just behind the Australian War Memorial is the Indigenous War Memorial. And though much smaller, it's no less important. It's here that a separate Indigenous memorial service is held on Anzac Day each year, where this unidentified soldier receives some recognition for his service to his country.